The founder and president of Women's Rights Without Borders, Reggie Littlejohn, joins us. She has testified 9 times on Capitol Hill, as well as around the world. Thank you so much for joining us. Can we just get to what this is all about, Reggie? Just boil it down to what we're looking at when a mayor of a city says, I'm considering vaccine mandates and passports.
Well, there's a couple of things at issue here, Eric. And by the way, thank you for having me on your show, and congratulations on your new show. But the vaccine mandates, these are things where people are not allowed to choose whether or not they have this vaccine. And I just think that that is a huge abrogation of our individual rights. And not only that, but they're shaming people. So, for example, in New York, the state senator, James Saunders, I'm going to get his words right. He says, you have the right to your body, of course, but you do not have the right to kill other people. Now, that is such an offensive statement to characterize people who have chosen not to have the vaccine, some for very valid medical or moral reasons, and characterize them as killing other people. That's trying to shame us into having vaccines. And according to a recent Trafalgar report, almost 60% of Americans believe that it is inappropriate for elected officials to attempt to shame people into having a vaccine.
You know, and I'm a free market person, Reggie. I believe businesses can decide whether to allow people into their restaurant or bar or sporting event. They can decide if they don't want to let unvaccinated people in, that's fine. You run the risk. It's when government gets involved. And this is where I draw the line. Government seems to be getting involved deeper and deeper into our personal lives. And I guess that's what you talk about when you talk about liberties and freedoms. Is this not an infringement on our liberty and freedom to decide whether or not I want to be vaccinated?
Well, it certainly is. And then there's a whole nother sort of hornet's nest of liberty and freedom issues that has to do with the vaccine passport. So we're not talking about the vaccine mandate where you're forced to have a vaccine and you don't want it. What we're talking about is the digital passport that carries your information on it about whether or not you're vaccinated.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
the platform that is used for that is a similar platform to the one of the China social credit system, which is a tool of mass surveillance and totalitarian control. And so we don't want to be setting up a platform that could be used in that way in the United States.
You know, is there a hypocrisy here where the same people are telling us we have to have a vaccine passport are the same people who tell us you don't need an ID to vote? Or the same people, these same people who say you need a vaccine to enter the United States as a foreigner, which came down today. If you want to get in, you can't come in without a vaccine passport. Yet, if you come through the southern border illegally, they ask you if you want to be vaccinated.
Well, that's exactly right. It's completely hypocritical to require people who are already here legally to have these vaccine passports and yet just wave people in on the southern border. And there's a real COVID crisis going on there. If they really care about COVID, they would be controlling it at the border.
Yeah.
So, yes, there is an element of hypocrisy there.
Reggie, really appreciate your time. Reggie Littlejohn, we'll bring you back because we want to talk about, we love talking about the violation of our personal liberties and freedoms because they are being at risk right now with this government. Thank you for joining us.